Hi, my name is Chava and I am the Director of Congregational Learning at Temple Sinai in Houston, Texas. Right now we're in a beautiful time of year. It's the month of Elul, it's the Jewish month of Elul, and we have 1 month until we go into Rosh Hashanah, the new year, 5781 this year. Anyway, with that in mind, I wanted to share with you what I call the MicroMOVEment guide. It originally is inspired by my teacher, Sark. I love Sark. She's the writer, the best-selling author of 18 books, and she's one of my many mentors. Sark has inspired me to look at how I learn new skills, make changes, and move forward differently. I'm sure I'm not alone when I say that sometimes I procrastinate. I know that may not be you, but it's absolutely me. I procrastinate whenever I need to do something for the first time. It's just who I am. Anyway, so Sark has this great process of having a fantastic idea. Now, she calls the MicroMOVEment miracles because she's really flowery with words. For me, I call it the MicroMOVEment guide because it's exactly what I'm doing. I'm picking something to do, a skill, a job, sometimes something huge, and I'm putting that in the middle, and then I'm thinking of all of the skills or things I need to do to make something happen. Well, Sark always starts with her purple pen. See? I love purple. In fact, I'm thinking about even making my hair purple soon. I can't wait. Maybe greenish purple, maybe like little streaks of green or turquoise through it. Just an idea, keep your eyes open, see what happens soon. Anyway, so Sark, her MicroMOVEment, her first movement towards anything that she wants to accomplish is she has her purple pen nearby. Me, mine is my mug. I love my mug. When I lived in Tucson, I fell in love with an artist named Mara, who I think is passed, but people still make her mugs, and I love the way they feel. So, I always have my mug close by. It's like comfort for me. And it's one small thing that I can do in order to accomplish my goal, because guess what? It's really easy to get a pen. It's really easy to get a mug or a drink or something, because what we all need to do is simply begin. Movement makes a difference. Action. If you're sitting still, it's not gonna happen. If you get up and do something, that's when things happen. So anyway, back to Sark. You can use this if you're wanting to learn a new skill with creativity. A few years ago, Sark inspired me to start painting again. In fact, what I do is I paint these little cards, and this is actually one I did the other day after reading a book. Commit and take action. They're little itty bitty cards. I do probably 1 to 3 a day. And it's the way that I motivate, inspire my creativity. Just a little something that I do. Some of us need help, whether or not it's cleaning out the closet, maybe it's self-care, and we need ways and we need to know what we're going to do to plan out how we're going to do self-care. It might be one of my things I'm thinking about making a MicroMOVEment wheel with is playfulness. I'm a pretty serious person. So how do I build playfulness into my life? Maybe this is one way that I'm going to try it with my MicroMOVEment guide. It could be about saving money. It could be about becoming a healthier person. There's so many ways that we can do it. Here, which I've made, is my MicroMOVEment guide. Here's one more way that you can do it. If you're interested in this template, go ahead and email me at learning@temple-sinai.org. If you reach out to me at learning@temple-sinai.org, temple-sinai.org, if you reach out to me there, I'm happy to send you this little template. You can do it in any way you want. Here's one way that I sometimes do it. So I like to make things fun and colorful. So here is my micro movement guide to making hummus. I love good hummus. And like while I can go up the road to Phoenicia's, I think I want to make my own hummus myself. So I had to figure out how to do it. And it's not as easy as you think. So the other side of that is that over the last year, I've gotten more into whole cooking. So I like using all of my own ingredients and I'm trying to be healthier and eat healthier. Anyway, to make hummus, I had been avoiding making hummus from scratch for years. Actually, it's a little ridiculous, but there you have it. That's procrastination. I'm not a major cook, so I had to figure out how to learn it. So this is what I did. I had to find a recipe. That was the first thing I did. So first I went on Facebook and I asked some friends, and then I went to Dr. Google and I asked some friends, and then I was visiting my friend Kathleen in South Padre, and she had a hummus recipe on a magnet. That was the first one I tried. Anyway, fantastic. I found a recipe, found two recipes. I tried it two or three times, but I need to get you to where I was. So I found a recipe, I had to buy the ingredients, dry garbanzo beans. I really wanted to make it from scratch. I think about recycling a lot, but what I'm hoping to do is create less trash. So I wanted to buy dried garbanzo beans. I needed to cook the beans, which is a huge thing because I had an Instapot and I figured that's what I should use, but I was intimidated by the Instapot. So much so that I had my son Dovey make it the first few times. I can now use my Instapot myself, but I had to use YouTube to figure out how to do it. So I had to make sure I had all of the ingredients, the spices, etc. Now, here's the most important ingredient that I actually mentioned, and I did my own little spot for tahini, was good tahini makes a huge difference on how you make the hummus. Big difference. So I assume really good hummus. Just sharing that. Anyway, you prepare all the ingredients. I roasted my own garlic. I actually would add a little bit of onion in because I add onion and garlic into everything that I can. And then I mix all the ingredients into my blender. Fantastic hummus came out. I was so excited. But I had to do this first because I was intimidated by that whole process. Anyway, it's hard. But here's the other thing. You know, if you actually, I just read this in like two different books within a month. One was Maria Forleo wrote a book, Everything is Figureoutable, and Chase Jarvis did a book called Creative Calling. And both said, if you can see the list of what you want every day, in this case, it's making hummus, but sometimes if you have five goals that you want to accomplish in a month, and you want to build on that, if you see it written and you look at it every day, you have a 42% better chance of reaching your goal. Think about that. It helps you by 42%. Now, I'm not a mathematician or a statistician, so I have no idea how they came up with that, but both of those books use the same 42% number. So I'm gonna think that they probably figured it out in some good possible way. So here's the other thing I do. Here I have a miracle map, magical map, I'm sorry. And I created this, and here's the thing. In the middle, I'm in the middle of writing a book called Living Out Loud, a Thriver's Journey. And I'm really excited. I'm probably past the halfway point now. I've been working on it for a year. And with Sark, again, Sark recommended was she asked some questions and I put it around my book and it was like, why do I write? To share my story and inspire others to thrive. Who endlessly believes in me? We all need to know who believes in us So I wrote the people that believe in me. And wow, I love that list. What do I do to get started on writing? I actually do a lot of things, like get my mug, I paint my little cards, I listen to some fantastic music and inspiring podcasts, and whenever I can, I go to the water. I run to the water. I love the beach. My goal is to keep getting my work done for my writing, but it really helps just making this little magical map, is what I'm calling it, inspires me, and it stays on my wall so that I could see it. And guess what? This week I've written 3 chapters for my book. Now, eventually I'm gonna have to edit all of those chapters and probably take half of them away, but at least I'm continuing to do the work. What are you trying to accomplish? Are you trying to accomplish a new routine, a new hobby? Whatever it is, you can do it. And I can't wait to hear how it gets done. Consider using the Micro Movement Guide as your way, or creating a magical map, or doing whatever makes it easier to leave procrastination behind and just get started. Lots of love, have a beautiful year, and I can't wait to hear how you use the Micro Movement Guide.